the last album, Made in Heaven, was quite slow, quite down, quite a lot of ballads, a lot of slow songs. And we thought it'd be nice if we did release a compilation of releasing the hard rock songs of Queen.
We thought it would be nice to give people what we never gave them, which is everything up. Like, an album was normally very full of light and shade. All our albums were like that. You would find something very strong and then something very gentle. And on purpose, you know, so that the album was very, very listenable to, I suppose. But we thought it'd be just great to have a great album that you can just bung in your car, whatever, and it rocks the whole way. I'm in love with my car.
Queen were, in essence, a hard rock band. This album represents a lot of the reasons why people liked us in the beginning.
Yes, there was ballads and yes, there were anthems and everything, but really it was a rock band. We will rock you. There were actually a lot of tracks available. I think probably twice as many tracks as we could get on the CD. So we were able to be very picky, and I think when you can be choosy, then you can make a good combination. If you listen to Queen Rocks, you can hear all through history, I guess 20 years or more, the hard rock end of what we did.
We span the decades like an aging duchess. So it's not a pop album and it's not a slow ballad album, but it's hard rock. Except the new song, which Brian happened to write and gave me a tape, said, what do you think of this song? And I actually forgot to listen to it for a while.
He put it away in a drawer somewhere, you know, because he was busy or whatever. And it was months later when Roger phoned up suddenly excited and said, I just listened to the track and it's amazing and we have to do it as a Queen song.
So we just got together and chemistry clicked back in, and it was really good fun. Really enjoyed working with Brian and John again.
It was very odd because it was the time when Princess Diana had just died, and he listened to it and he could hear it was about Freddie, and he could also hear it was about Princess Diana. He could also hear it was about Gianni Versace and all these things, and he said, I'm sure this is an important thing and we should be doing it as Queen. It shouldn't be something fancy, you know. The song is not a fancy song where you have this big set, you know, and you're very heroic. It's not that kind of thing. It's very simple and very direct and human. So the only way to do it is to base it around just playing. You know, it's called a performance video. And within that, you have to tell the story and create the atmosphere.
The word clip is understatement and grown up.
An angel reaching for the sky. Is it raining in heaven? Do you want us to cry?
So we started off very simple, and Rudy put together this set, which was actually, I mean, it looks like there was no set at all, but actually it's quite, it's carefully done, you know. It looks like we're in a studio or in a rehearsal place, And it looks like perhaps we're running through the song and learning it. That was the sort of theme. So we relaxed, and we're not conscious of performing to an audience at all. We're only performing to each other, and we're sort of feeling things out. That's the atmosphere of the video. No one but you.
It had the feel of a nice, of a good quality thing, you know, like the long travelling shots. And we were just trying to give the feel, really, that it was a serious, you know, it wasn't, we were not trying to be flashy, you know, no tricks. And this was the band in just playing the song, really, just very simply in a room somewhere.
If we were making a Queen video, Freddie would be at the piano or a gig, you know. And for instance, there would be cups and stuff on the piano, and there would be cups and, you know, and Freddie would take a sip of whatever. And if it was a gig, there would be a glass of champagne here, because at some point he would say, cheers, darlings, or whatever, you know. The camera is kind of always on the move. It's like you visited the set, like you were just walking around, and you could see around me, you can go around there and see Roger, and you can see John. You know, normally videos are shot here, 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 you know, but this isn't. This is like you wander around, so maybe you're a visitor. I don't know who you are. You know, you have to ask the question who you are.
I think we all always feel somehow that he's around, because we live with him for so many years. You know how he would react to any given situation. So you imagine in your head he'd be saying, oh, stop that, you know, don't be ridiculous. Or, you know, in a way, I suppose it did feel a little bit that way, yeah. The sense of your leaving was in the way.
Great position, I love it on the side there.
Yeah. It's also, you see, the mic was always something within the way, you know? We don't need it. It's real, because you're real.
Yeah.
Rudy and, you know, we all had a lot of contact with the band and with Freddie over a long period of time. And good man, you know, top of the range. And today was very, very special.
This is my personal view, and it's not an official Queen statement, but I think that you should actually answer your mobile phone and ask me the question again.
I'll turn it off, yeah. I'm going to rewind just because we're short of time, sorry.
Take two. Well, the video we are about to shoot tomorrow, I see as the third of a visual trilogy, which started with I'm Going Slightly Mad.
I'm going slightly mad.
Continued with Days of Our Lives. And is now with No One But You, or Only the Good Die Young, comes to a third part of the climax or the finish of that trilogy. We didn't know it was a trilogy when we started on it.
We are today trying to make a little scene of how not to film a video, you see? These days...
It's very convincing.
Yeah, very convincing, yeah. The band is featuring somebody on guitar, I forgot his name, but What's his? Oh yes. See. Oh, so this try to come into my nose and.
The last shot was of the champagne glass, just so that we had it covered, and I was very keen that we should have it in case, you know, because you never know how you cut, how you finally edit a video. Sometimes you change your mind in the edit, and we had a final shot, all planned. No one but you. But then we thought, well, you know, maybe this glass, which has been there all along, would be a nice way to end as well. And in the end, there's just one spotlight on it, and then Rudy goes, cut. And just before he goes, cut, something happened. And I went, what was that? Did something happen? And everybody said, no, I don't think anything happened. Anyway, we ran the thing back, and you see this little tiny moth come down, and it sort of wheels around the glass, and then off into space.
Come on, kids.
I mean, moths is just what
get
you
into the last
find.
Setup.
Look!
I mean, in the beginning, they called us heavy metal when they weren't calling us glam or whatever, you know. Which seems funny now. But a lot of Queen's output, whether in the studio or on stage, and more on stage, was rock.
It's not quite the same as releasing an entirely new album that you've been working on, all new material for the last, you know, year and a half or whatever. But it's still a project, and it's still, I think, an album which hangs together musically very well. I mean, it's quite a hard listen. Great car for in the car, and it rocks, you know, and it's a side of Queen that I liked a lot.